Okay. Let's go. Hilchos Tefillin, Halacha Hey. Just when we start, everybody's gone. All right. Okay, not, of course, you. Okay, Hilchos Tefillin, Halacha Hey. We are in the middle of Yud Aleph. So we say that we explained that the Tefillin is the Moichin. That's the mentality, that's the brain. It's the overall awareness which allows a person the ability to marich ruche, to take a deep breath, so to speak, and endure whatever it is that he has to go through. And from the merchant themselves, we have, you know, that's the generator, the generator, and you have the cables that are coming down. This is the ritzus, you know, the straps. And the interface of the straps and the tefillin is called the ma'abata. Ma'abata is the pass-through. The ma'abata is the tunnel in the tefillin, in the batim, through which the straps are going through. That's called the ma'abata. The ma'abata is p'chinas mavar yabok. Arizal explains. This is the Shem Havaya and Shem Elokim together. Is Gematria Yabok. It's 112. It's, I believe it's 19. I don't know. Why should I get myself in trouble? Whatever it is. Together, this is what it is. Gematria Yabok. Yabok is Rashateva Shichud. Kedusha Bracha. Yichud. Yichud. So the Yud is Kaviochal in the Chochma Bina. I mean, Chochma. Kesel Chochma. And the Kedusha is in the Vav Ktzoras from Chesed until Yesod, and Bracha is the Malchus. So the Yichud from top to bottom, from the Moichin, from the mentalities, all the way down to implementation, is called Yichud, Kedusha, Bracha. This is that tunnel inside the button is called Ma'avarta, which is a Pchinas Ma'avar Yabok. It says like this, and when a person is able through, when the Ritzus of the film gives a person the capability to endure everything, because there's an overriding understanding that he has regarding what is going on in his life, and he doesn't let anything bother him, doesn't let anything, you know, break him. What it does is the mitzvahs, the kedusha, what they do is they sweeten and ameliorate the inyan of retzua bisha. Retzua Bisha is a strap that the Zohar calls Retzua Bisha la'alkoy chayava. That's the strap of punishment that exists in this world in order to punish those that are chayav. He explained that in reality, everything in life is either this or that. When Kadosh Baruch Hu is light, when a person has averus, is Gehenna. And the same light, if a person doesn't have averus, is Natati Lechem, Nirei Shmi, Shemir Tzedoko, Umapa Bechnafer. There's refuah in its wings. Chazal says on this pasuk, Osed Lovoy, Osed Kadosh Baruch Hu Loitzi Chomo Menatiko. In the future, Kadosh Baruch Hu is going to take the sun out of his sheath, and the light of the sun is going to be much stronger. The Rishoyim, the Medrash, the Rishoyim are going to burn. As Rav Aaron Yitzchak said, like the zapper of mosquitoes. That's his mashal for that. And
talking about holy light.
Yeah.
Talking about
physical light as well. Physical light is a manifestation of a principle. See, the thing is that the light that we have today is just, you know, the light of the sun, and the whole thing is a derivative of the light of the Kodesh Baruch Hu.
In the Gemara, when we say that you see the light of the sun in the moon, it's the idea that you can see the source, even though you're looking at a secondary point.
That's right. That's right.
So this is saying
that it's not only this, but the source downgrades and steps down.
Right. Is that why the moon will be the same brightness as the sun? Once the sheath is off the moon, off the sun, so then it's just going to be light.
I don't know. You're talking about an occult that I cannot possibly tell you. I mean, I could make something up if you want.
Okay.
But the tachlis is that when a person knows that everything that happens to him is for his own taiva, he's able to overcome everything. Because the same kind of difficulties that you face, challenges that you face, can build you or break you. You know, as they say, that which doesn't break you builds you, you know? Okay, forget about it. I'm not gonna say it. I'm okay. Oh, stop looking at So basically, when a person overcomes, just overlooks whatever goes in his life, it doesn't let him confuse him from avodas Hashem. First of all, the Ritzua Kadisha of that film, which brings about the amelioration of the dinim, cancels out the Ritzua Bishel al kol chayava, the bad strap, you know, the mean strap rather, you know, that beats up the chayov and the chatoim. We said that the reality of Kodesh Baruch Hu is one. When a person is chayav, when a person is a sinner,
what's the bad strap?
So I'm saying there is a strap is like a cat of nine tails, you know, the thing that they used to flog the criminals. It's called Ritzuach Bisho, it's called the bad Ritzuach, the bad strap. So we say there is a good strap and a bad strap, they're one and the same. The life of Kodesh Baruch Hu is one. When a person leaves this world, you know, nobody has to, there's no one has to take him to any trials. He just, when he leaves this world over here, he's arguing, you know, should the United States Congress do this, on this, should do that, and this and that, and whatever it is. He goes out of this world. Kodesh Baruch Hu meets him. Anochi Hashem Elokecha. That's it. Immediately that's the Gehenna, immediately that's the Gan Eden, according to how, you know, how you lived your life. You know, it's like, you see, like this table, you know? If I go like this, this table is the reality. If I go like this, you know, I get caressed. Or is this a prize? And if I hit it, I get hit. Is this a punishment? It is and it isn't. You know, it is because, yeah, it's a reaction to what I do, but it isn't because I'm the one who is caressing myself, I'm the one who is punishing myself. So he's saying that Kodesh Baruch Hu, you know, brings the nisyonis to a person in this life.
It's up to us.
And it's up to you how you receive them. If, you know, there's averus involved, if there are averus involved, then chas v'chalila, then it's the trial and tribulations that happen to a person break him down. This is at that point in time, the Surim is called Ritzua Bisha, bad strap or mean strap, punishing strap. You know, like something like a belt, you know, to hit somebody. But but if a person, you know, takes the union of Ritzuah Kadisha, the Ritzuah of Tefillin, which brings about the aura, the longevity from the Tefillin, and brings about to his, in other words, the main thing is I'm living my life now. It's not about whether I'm going to have a good time or a bad time, I'm going to have, you know, a good steak or a steak, or it's not about that. It's about going through life and gathering whatever it is that I can in Avodat Hashem. So that in itself, and whatever is happening in between, B'seder has to be dealt with. You don't, you know, you don't just let it go. You don't just, just forgo whatever it is that you need to do. You do what you need to do. It is not only is it working for you, but it's also mevatel the yisura. It's also mevatel, which you don't get all tangled up, you don't get all worked up with whatever yisura it is that you're going through. So he says, this is ma'abata shel tefillin. V'zeh b'chinas ma'abata shel tefillin. Shesham uvrim ha'ritzuos. This is the passage of the tefillin where the ritzuos are going through. This is the passage of Yabok, as we said before. Yabok is, as we said before, this is the two names of Shem Avaya, Shem Elokim together. This is the principle of I praise Hashem when Hashem is revealing Himself to me. It's Shem Avaya, which is the Chasodim. Be'elokim alal davar is when I praise Hashem when He appears upon me with Shem Elokim, which is judgment. She'tzrichim la'akir ha'yisoy izboch, v'izkar ha'olav tamid ben betivo, ben ve'aku. You always have to come closer to Kodesh Baruch Hu, sigh when things are fun, and sigh when they are not so much fun, chas v'shalom. Ben be'aliyah ben berida, when it is that you're having a good time and you're coming close, and you feel spiritual, and you feel holy. The Ben Birida, when you find yourself that you fall off the face of the earth, and you're falling into things that you really should not be doing. This is the principle of I'm going to praise Hashem when I go up, and I'm going to praise Hashem when I go down. This is that proficiency, the kiyas. This is the boki that the Rabbeinu says that person has to be boki ba'alocha. Person has to be proficient knowing what the halacha is. Now ultimately the main halacha, that overriding halacha of everything, is that you should always find a way to Kodesh Baruch Hu no matter what goes on you. No matter what goes over you, whatever what transpires in your life, you should always come close to Kodesh Baruch Hu and find yourself where you are. There's a certain kind of things that you need to do when you have Merchand Gadlus, how you should behave. You know, we have expanded consciousness and you're really with it and you feel like davening and learning and everything else. And there are certain things that you do, certain kind of regimen that you need to adapt when you don't feel us doing anything. You don't feel like davening, you don't feel like doing things. There's in any which way, you know, and the thing is that to know how to deal with when you're up and how to deal when you're down is a vitius, is a proficiency. You're going to be a professional about this. The Rebbe says that in Esak Shamayim Shamato, he says in this Torah, if I ascend to the heaven, there you are. Atzia Sheol Ineka, if I make my bed in the bottom rung of Gehenna, Rachman Ratzan, you are with me, Ineka, you're right there. From this you learn from the different allusion of the David HaMelech is saying in Tehillim, you see that the way to handle it is Esak Shamayim, if I go all the way up to the heaven, Shamata, you're still far. Shamata, you're still far away from me. I haven't even begun to do anything. Atziah Sheol, you find yourself, you're a total bum, you know, a failure, you know, for the ages, as they say. Hinekosh Bochum, you're right there with me. You're right there with me, just the way I am. and nobody can megal the kedusha of Kodesh Baruch Hu, the gedula Kodesh Baruch Hu, the way you can, right in your greatest hour of need. And the ability to be able to tell, you know, to switch the mode of behavior from when you're up and when you're down, you know, to know that, because the Yetzer Hara wants to do the opposite. I was like, when you're up, like, whoa, man, check me out. You know, like, forget about it. You know, Sakshem Haim, Hineka, there you are, you know, I got you. You know, Tzir Shiol, Shamata, you're not there. This is what the Yetzer Hara, you know, that's what they say, that the Aser Satan Milfaneinu Nachareinu, you know, remove the Satan before us and behind us. This is the before us, before the mitzvah, the Satan says, you're going to do a mitzvah? Who do you think you are? You just, yeah, forget about it. And after you did the mitzvah, whoa, you're really something special. He says, you're supposed to switch it. You're supposed to be the other way around. I once said that the Neumann HaMelech brings very interesting knetch in this union of the, what Chazal said, the Gemara says, anybody that lives in Chutz La'aretz is like a Misha Ein La'eloka, as if he doesn't have a God. He resembles somebody who has a God. So the Neumann HaMelech says, if you look well into the Chazal, it means Kol Adar Be'etz Yisrael he resembles somebody as a God, which means he really doesn't have. He's like somebody who has, which means he really doesn't have. And a koladar bechutz la'aretz, anybody who lives in chutz la'aretz, domeh kemishen eloka, which means really he has. He just resembles somebody who doesn't have. You know, he switches over the entire chazal. So, and he is mefarsh, whatever is mefarsh over there, dokak doisho. But you can say that this is the pshat. When you are pchinas kol adar be'etz Yisrael, they say Eretz Yisrael is gvoya mikol ha'aretz, is the highest of all. That's the one lo gushma biyom zam. This is where it rains first in Eretz Yisrael. It's the highest of all lands. The Rebbe says that any tzaddik they cannot show. You know, the Bnei Aliyah, those that live the Bnei Mala, that haven't even begun. And Dara Mata, those that live in the cellar, that Hashem is with them, ain't a tzaddik klal. It's not, b'chlal nishkan tzaddik. So Anna said, you know, tzaddik klal means, can be an individual tzaddik, it's not a tzaddik of a klal, you know, it's not a manik. Okay, say that. Be it as it may, Eretz Yisrael is gavoa mikol ha'aretz, kol adar be'etz Yisrael, talking about those that are tzaddikim. Doime kemi sheyesh lo Elokah, he thinks he already has Hashem. Be'emet, I haven't even started. Kol adar b'chutz la'aretz, daremata, those that are low, doime kemi sheyesh lo Elokah, he thinks, he's in his dimyon, he doesn't have a Kadosh Baruch Hu, be'emet yesh lo, but Kadosh Baruch Hu is with him, by him. עיין שם שכתב שכל מי שרוצה לעשות תשובה, anybody wants to do תשובה, צריך להיות. בסדר.
But I hear it, I'm like...
Okay, so the Asad Nosson wants. You're asking very good, I'm very glad you asked it. It's a good thing you asked, okay. Anyhow, you're going to get a little tobacco. No, okay, that's
all. I'll be sneezing through.
You'll be sneezing throughout the whole
thing. I'll pan the camera this way.
All right. They asked Reb Nosson whether the tzaddikim that are making all these drushes for Maran Chazal, did Chazal also have it in mind? Which is basically what you're asking. Is that the pshat of what they were saying? He says, but did they mean it? So he said, no. They didn't have it in mind. He says, but what they said on such a high level of truth, of emes, that it fits all the other perushim as well. Because when the emes, you know, is kibbutz shifos tzela, the divrei Torah is like a hammer, you know, that beats the rock. Mischalik lekama nitzotzos, that you have sparks flying all over. So the hit is so true that it fits, and all the drashas that the tzaddikim are darshan on דברי חז"ל. So it says like this, מי שרוצה לעשות תשובה, anybody wants to do תשובה, צריך להיות בוקי בהלוכה, he has to be בוקי בהלוכה, he has to be proficient in הלוכה. What does it mean here? בוקי ברצו, בוקי בשור. You have to be proficient what to do when you are ratzo, when you're running up and you're coming close to Hashem, boki b'shov, and you know exactly what to do in your downtime. Boki b'ayel, to be proficient when you go up. Boki b'nofik, to be boki when you go down. Bifchinasim etzak shamayim shamato, atzia sholineko. If I ascend the heavens, there you are. Atzia sholineko, here you are. עיין שמענו שצריכים לראות עסקה לשם לצבורך תמיד בכל מקום שהוא. You have to see, to get close הקדוש ברוך הוא, no matter where you are. Say if you are the most brilliant boy in your class or you are the dumbest boy in your class, no matter what you think about yourself. You know, if you are the most rich man in society or the poorest one that can't put two pennies together. It doesn't matter. It's all one and the same. בכל מקום שהוא, בין בעלייה, בין בירידה, in any place you are, say when you have an aliyah, and you have a yirida. ואפילו אם בשעות תחתית, even a person who finds himself in the lowest rung of גיהינו רחמון לצלן, גם משם יכול לזכר ולהב לסבור בכלל הציע שאולי נקו. From there also he can come close to הקדוש ברוך הוא, it says, והציע שאולי נקו, if I make my bed in the lowest rung of גיהינו, there you are. Here you are. All this constitutes that stoicism, that kind of equanimity with which you take everything that goes over you. You know, take a deep breath and just go over, you know, stoically through everything that goes through your life. No matter what, will be whatever will be. Don't let anything in the world, no matter what, break you down. And start getting close to Kodesh Baruch Hu or at all times. Restart and reboot all over again. If you do this, you will never get tired, you'll never get weary. Even if you are zoche to a tremendous ascent, to an incredible madrega, you should know that even בהקדוש ברוך הוא נמצא השם מבחינת שמשק שמיים שם מטו. Even בשמיים הקדוש ברוך הוא is there in an aspect of שם מטו, there you are, you're still far. שאף הפי שנדמה שעלה לשמיים, even so you say, whoa, you know, I reached the heaven themselves. עדיין הצורך לבקש שם משברוך התחיל מחדש, you have to love הקדוש ברוך הוא, and start all over again. כי גם בשמיים נמצא שם מזבח. Even in the heavens, הקדוש ברוך הוא is there. In other words, he's beyond you, and you have to start all over again. משה כל זה ביום התואר, כי תצא למלחומו, in ליקוטי תנאי נשים מפי בייס. שכל זהו בחינה שריך הספיים. This is this emotional, mental equilibrium, you know, that balance that you're supposed to keep at all times. שזורך על המצוות תפילים כנראה. This is what you get through the mitzvah of tefillin. Ze b'chinas ma'abarta, and this is the ma'abarta, that's that passage in the bayit of the tefillin. B'chinas ma'abar yabok, this is the passage of yabok. At the bottom of the tefillin, have the passage where the straps go through. That's called ma'abarta. So we're talking about that part of the tefillin. That's the interface. The tefillin itself is the generator, and the ritzuas kaviyachol are the cables, and the ma'abalt is the interface between the moichin and the cables, between the generator and the ze pchinas ma'abal, ze pchinas yabok. Sorry? Okay. Ze pchinas, vezeo pchinas ma'abalta, this is the ma'abalt, pchinas ma'abal yabok. Ki yabok is oisyas boki, it's the same letters of boki. Has boki beratzav, boki beshov, as Rabbeinu said sham, over there in this interval. Shabchinas boki, shabchinas yabok, ayin sham basof. Vegam, yabok begimatria avay elokim. Yabok is in gimatria, Hashem, avay Hashem elokim, as we said, b'Hashem alel davar, b'elokim alel davar. You're supposed to keep your minds, your wits about you, no matter if you go up or you go down. Say if it's a midah of mercy, say it's a midah of judgment. Ben b'tivu, ben b'aku. Say when things are going well, and say when things are going difficultly. Ben b'aliyah, ben b'irida. Say when you're going up, and say when you're going down. תמיד צריך לעבוד השם יצבורך, you should always serve הקודש ברוך הוא, ולעריך רוחוי, and be patient, and keep your wits about you, לבל ייפו ולא ייגו ולא יסבט ומתשוקוס לשם יצבורך. Don't fall, and don't falter, and don't fall off from your yearning to הקודש ברוך הוא, משום דבר בעולם, no matter what happens to you. וכל זה זוכם לגעת תפילין. All this you get through the mitzvah of תפילין, שהוא עריך הספריים. That's this kind of wisdom that sees everything, that bridges everything, that from the very beginning sees already what the very end is, and making from the beginning of life to the end of life, everything is one. But this is b'chinas ariches yom, and this is longevity, this is old age. The old age which is made out of starting to live each and every moment, over and over and over again. But it comes, but how do you get the koach to restart? Whoa, I mean, I'm getting tired already. How do you get to koach to restart? Because you have an overriding istakhlus, you know, an overall look on the whole, on this whole business called life, this whole matara, that you understand all these are just details. You know, one of the big mistakes that they make.
Zaken Ayurel also.
Hmm?
Zaken Ayurel.
Right. The thing that they make, that they started making this mistake in the Vietnam War, and it keeps on getting worse and worse all the time. The thing is that the kind of perspective that you take gives you a certain image of what is right and what is wrong. The Second World War, there were, you know, basically towards the end of the war, you know, President Truman ordered the atomic bomb and they killed hundreds of thousands of people. You know, and each one in Hiroshima and one in Nagasaki. The thing is that the reason why he did it is because the estimate was if the American have to land in Japan, you know, and win the war on the ground like General MacArthur wanted, they estimated American casualties alone at 1.5 million. A million and a half soldiers. And many more Japanese, even more Japanese would die because of that. So by taking a perspective which is far off, you know, the long-term perspective, the Rachmanis was actually Shemir Achem to kill, you know, 200,000 people in one shot, because it saved millions. But today, they bring you pictures from everywhere.
Wow.
They bring you pictures from everywhere. You know, for what's happening in the very, very... So suddenly, you see, you know, that even terrorists are suffering. They make them eat. Yeah. You know, in Guantanamo, whatever it is, they make them eat. They go on hunger strikes. You're talking about terrorists that want to kill women and children. And they force them to eat against their will. What achzarius, what cruelty. The point is, when you get too close, you lose the bigger picture.
Too close to what?
You take a look at the chair that they put the prisoners there when they have to feed them with the zonda, you know, they go through the nose like, so you get too close, like, whoa, look at this cruelty. That's cruelty. You're looking too close. So suddenly everybody has rights. You know, children have rights, animals have rights. If people will start taking pictures from a microscope, the next thing people will say that medicine is murder. Bacteria rights. You know what the drama is going on, you know, on this?
Organisms.
Yeah, millions of them you're killing. You know, you're mass murder. You're killing millions of bacteria. The point is, it's what the perspective is. You can't come too close, you can't come too far. The main perspective is that you have to take a perspective on the entire life.
Hiroshima was not a chesed. Hiroshima was not a chesed.
No, he's saying
it was a chesed, it was a rachamim.
It wasn't too far away.
I'm not going to go into the.
Their estimates could have been wrong. Their estimates could have been wrong.
100%.
And they went back to eighth grade and destroyed a lot of people and hurt many.
Okay.
The interesting thing is Truman, when he made that decision, because he was like a very pushy guy. He was a very straight man. He wasn't.
He said it's a bigger piece of artillery, so he used it.
He took a very pragmatic approach.
Nobody was talking about the fact that they were killing 100,000 Japanese in the regular bombing of Tokyo.
Right.
200,000 people would die in Dresden. You know, that was and Goebbels cried, you know, look at the cruelty of the Allies.
Agav, in researching what we were looking at last week, he said that the estimates of Stalin personally murdered 26 million people.
Yes.
Personally?
Yeah.
Just him. Yeah. So last question, who's worse, Hitler or Stalin? Hitler or Stalin? Yeah. It's all a matter of perspective.
There's no doubt. There's no doubt that Hitlerism was no big evil to Stalin. There's no doubt about that. And there's no doubt that Stalin was evenly matched foil for Hitler. There's also no doubt in my mind that without a Stalin, Hitler could never have been defeated. There's just no way.
He was willing to sacrifice.
He was willing to sacrifice millions of Russians. That's the only way you could kill. You can finish Hitler. It's the only way that could be done.
That was the end.
So he may, you know, the Kodesh Baruch Hu can deal with achzorius, with pure cruelty, to affect rachamim, to affect mercy. A doctor can administer poison to save the life of a person. He can also cut off a limb to save the life of a person. You know, they can do that. But the question is, what is the overall kavana? The overall kavana is over, but what we're talking about here is the overall perspective of life, which is called Chaim Aruchim, which is called longevity. You see the entire picture, from beginning of life to the end of life. And this gives you the koyach to restart each and every time. What?
In the Nevuah of Yecheskel, about the third base of Mikdash, the area where the Mashiach walks in, you know, the Mashiach has his own gate, he comes through the middle. That
this
area, what's that? It's called Yabok. That's the name of it in the Nevuah. So you see the connection between Mashiach as the person who's going to teach us this ability, how to go through.
His interface between.
Yeah, amazing.
This is the long straps that are going through Mahabharata. And through this, you go over everything. You get over all the suffering. And all the obstacles, the confusions. They come from Ritzua Bisho. You know, we're not really doing what we need to do. According to the Madreda, where we want to get to, it's going to a bisho. When it's battle, I call connect the arichasapayim. When you are patient, because you see the overall picture, it all falls before you. V'ze pchinas v'yavor Hashem al pano. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu passed over Moshe. She's pchinas ma'abalto. V'az k'shover Hashem al pano. When HaKadosh Baruch Hu has gone over Moshe. As Gilul Hashem Yisborach 13 midos shel Rachamim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu has revealed to him the 13 traits of Rachamim. Shem Kleser Tikkun HaDikno. This is the 13 rectification of the beard of the Keser Elyon. Sham Nemar Vemar Moshe. This is the Moshe. Quickly, Moshe fell on his face. So Chazal said, Mar, what did he see that he fell on his face? Erech Hapayim. He saw the main midah of the 13 midos, which is Erech Hapayim, patience. The stoicism that stems from the fact that you see the entire picture. This is b'chinas tefillin. Shira el chapaim shezo b'chinas tefillin. Shadeizo v'rim al hakol. This is how you get over everything. V'zoch ha'nizkarim elav yisboach. And this is how you're zoche to come close to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, not only despite whatever happens to you, but using whatever happens to you. everything that you overcome becomes a stepping stone to get closer to Kodesh Baruch Hu. זה בחינס מהבטה, זה בחינס מהבטה, זה go over, ויעבור, this is passing over. כי אז כשבר שם הפנוב, when הקדוש ברוך הוא came over משה רבינו וגילה לו 13 מיני של רחמים, שם את ליסת יקוד הדיקנו, when he revealed to משה רבינו the 13 קצב רחמים, which is the 13 rectification of the beard, אז גילה לו בחינס עורר התפילון. Then he revealed to משה רבינו the secret of the light of תפילון. כמו שכוסף בשם הפרשה, זה written there in the parasha, אני אעביר כל טובי על פניך, וראיס עשה חוירה, I will pass all my goodness before you, and you will see my behind. And what does Rashi says, וראיס עשה חוירה, what did he see? קשר של תפילון. He saw the קשר of תפילון. This is what he saw, this is החוירה. He said, וראיס עשה חוירה, וזה דרשו, אז זה קשר של תפילון. This is קשר של תפילון. That's the knot of תפילון. כי עיקר תפילון, the main in of תפילון, נמשוך משם מבחינת תיקוד הנקנה. It all comes from this rectification of the beard, which is the ultimate רחמים that supersedes everything. שם 13, מידל שהוא מבחינת ערך הפיים. So like this, ועיקר ריחס הפיים, and the main aspect of ריחס הפיים, this kind of stoic acceptance of what's going on, Zoichem al de'eretz Yisrael. This is your Zoichem through de'eretz Yisrael, which is the embodiment of Amunah. Shehu b'chines Amunah. Kmo shekosu b'tor yonah, v'imayir Moshe, ayen sham, shezeh b'chines tefil. Ki ha'parsha shebatfil medabrim eretz Yisrael ve'amunah. What is the parsha of the tefil? What is the moichem? What is the mentality? The intellect in the tefil? What does it speak of? What does the moichem speak of? It speaks of eretz Yisrael. V'yakisovoy, v'chule. And it speaks about Amunah. ועיקר שני הפרשס, הראשונס, the first two parshas, ומניין, they speak about what? It says, מצרים וביאס ארץ ישראל. As it is said over there, זכורס היום הזה שיצאתם ממצרים, והיה כי אביא אחר השם אל הארץ. Remember that you went out of מצרים, and השם brought you to ארץ ישראל. וכן הפרשה השניות, the second parsha also the same as, והיה כי אביא אחר. And it will be then when HaKadosh Baruch Hu brings you to Eretz Yisrael. Ki ikar ha'tefillin, the main essence of the tefillin, the principle behind the tefillin, the secret behind the tefillin, and b'chines ha'riches ha'payim, that kind of patience, shezuchem ad Eretz Yisrael, that you are zoicha through Eretz Yisrael. Shu efech Mitzrayim, this is exactly the opposite of the essence of Mitzrayim. Shimela gilulim avodah zorah, Mitzrayim is full. With the Vazazora and with Gilul Shepech Amunah, this is the opposite of Amunah. Well, Ken Kshayu Mitzrayim, when they were Mitzrayim, Moshe Rabbeinu tried to tell them they were suffering, they were going through trials and tribulations. They couldn't hear Moshe Rabbeinu because they were impatient because of the Avodah Kasha. In other words, they were perturbed and disturbed by the circumstances of their living. In other words, El Chapayim, that whatever circumstances of your living are, it doesn't disturb you from listening and hearing it.
Get that down.
Right? They could not get closer to the Tzaddik. In Mitzrayim, they couldn't listen. They couldn't get closer to the Tzaddik. They couldn't get closer to the Tzaddik. To listen to him. מס קוצר רוח, מכל קוצר רוח, you know, because it's impatient. שהוא הפך הריח הספיים, that's the opposite of patience, of הריח הספיים. שעל ידי זה עיקר הזכר וזה שם יצבור לך הצדיקים האמיתיים. The main way, the only way, to get close to הקדש ברוך הוא, the true צדיקים, is through this patience. Patience, perseverance, endurance, הריח הספיים, כמו שראו בתואר הכנל. כי עיקר הריח הספיים זוכים על ידי אמונו. The main הריח הספיים, how do you get? You get through אמונו if you believe. You have no problem, you can get through it. Shu b'chinas Eretz Yisrael, shu b'chinas tefillin. As we said, we're returning to the same moshels, we have some new faces over here. So we can explain that the same pinprick can be a frightening thing, or, you know, as we said, when you go for blood test in Kopat Cholim, you give over your arm, go ahead and put the needle in. And over here you feel it, and over here you feel it. But when you don't understand, you don't believe in the tachlis of why you're being pricked, it's a very frightening experience. But when you know they're going to give you a blood test, which is your own good, so you feel a little tip and it's over. It's not a big deal. You know, after a second, it's finished. So through the emuna, when you have the emuna, when you know what the tachlis is, you know what it's for, so it's just, you know, objectively, you know, it tips a little bit, that's it. You don't make a big megillah out of it. You just, okay, it's finished, it's done, it's over. You take a little of this, and then you can show everybody, look. Look, I have a hole in my arm. Sorry about that. And therefore, and that's why, that since you're talking about coming out of Mitzrayim from a state of confusion and discombobulation from whatever happens to you, to Eretz Yisrael, which is a state of Arichis Apayim, of patience, since this you can get when you acquire Emunah. The second two parshas, medabri me'emuna, they already speak of emuna, which enables the passage from Mitzrayim, which is impatience, which is frustration, to Eretz Yisrael, which is patience and endurance. Against emuna, shema Yisrael, shum nasa yichud, v'parshas v'ayayim shamo, shum gam medaber, gam kabolos ol mitzvot v'bitul avodah zarah. We're talking about Vayam Shemoah that speaks from the acceptance of the yoke of mitzvahs, or bitul avodah zarah, and the cancellation of the avodah zarah, shu b'chinas chalon af, which is anger. Chalon af is, again, anger is the opposite of patience, of stoic acceptance. Moshe Kosov Sham. Yishamru lachem, penifta levavchem, should be very careful that your heart will not sway, v'sartem, v'avantem, Elohim Acharim, and you will worship idols. And what's going to be the results? Immediately, V'chor Af Hashem Akev Hashem Yirachem. It brings Chor Af, as we said, Chazal said, Avodah Zorah Ba'olam, Chor Af Ba'olam. Whenever there's Avodah Zorah in the world, there's a Metzis Avodah Zorah in the world, there is anger in the world. V'sav Elohim Acharim Nimtza, Shekol Arba Pashas Shel HaTefillin, so you see that all the four Pashas of the Tefillin, they speak of Yetzias Mitzrayim, Shebchinas Avodah Zorah, they come coming out of Avodah Zorah. Shu b'chinas chalon af. This is the principle of anger, the principle of impatience, kotzer ruach. Liskus atzeitz misham, to be zoche, to get out of it, lavo l'Eretz Yisrael, to come to Eretz Yisrael. Shu b'chinas emuna. Al b'chinas arichas apayim. That's the endurance, that's the patience. Kizeh ikar b'chinas atfilon. This is the essence of what the tefillin is supposed to do for you. You're supposed to take it out of seeing everything from a myopic view of the moment to expand your perspective to see what this entire life is about. Because a person is it's very tempting to see what's happening with me right now. How do I feel right now? Do I feel good now? Do I feel bad now? Am I happy now? Am I not happy now? You know, the entire society is like going through this ceaseless, you know, measuring of the pulse of happiness. Am I happy? No, I'm not happy. So let me have, instead of 15 megabytes of internet, I have 30, I have 50, I have 100 megabytes, then I'm going to be happy. You're going to see other junk. This is exactly the same thing. You know, so then let's say that more things will be allowed. And more things will be allowed. You know that everything is going to be allowed. Then we're going to be happy. We're going to be happy. Exactly the opposite. They're running away from happiness. He says that. So the passage to real good life, to a life that always starts and never ends, is the secret of getting out of Mitzrayim, getting to Eretz Yisrael, b'chinas emunah, b'chinas arichas apayim. That's the main essence of what films are. What does it say? The very end. So if you finish all this entire thing, you're zeche to total longevity. You're zeche to eternal life. Your life, every moment is long, and every moment is brand new. You're zeche, that's the essence of longevity. I know, arichas yomim. That's the end of long life. She's looking that film. That's the long life that one gets through the film. This is the essence of patience and endurance and taking things in stride. Arichas ruach, you know, taking a deep breath. Shemisham arichas yomim. This is where long nights come from. Kikar achaim aduach neshima. You know, the life comes through, you know, the ruach of the breathing. This is the deep breath. The patience comes of patience, if, you know, of full perspective, in of zoken shebekdusha. Because it is typically, what's the difference between an old man and a young man? That the old man can look back and have the perspective of life as a whole. When a person is young, he's still building what life is. Or maybe, who knows, maybe this is good and this is bad. But when you're passing everything, when you already went over everything, the essence of true oldness, of old, true old age, is where you acquire the wisdom to see the whole thing in perspective. Because the whole life is actually one thing. Your entire life is one big poem, big song that you are singing to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. This is long life. Anybody who is easy to anger, you know, who throws around a foaming rage, is like, none of us, of course. I heard that somebody far away that was like that. Chaim enough Chaim, his life is not a life. Is somebody that has no patience. It doesn't have any capacity, has no bandwidth. The length of a paim. That's why his life is not a life. The main chaim is the lengthening of the ruach. Why? Each and every one of us, we meet challenges every single day. The direction that society is going in around us, and they tell us this is what is good, is babyism. Everybody wants to be a baby. A baby, you know, can cry, so he gets food. He soils himself, so he changes his diaper. You take care of his every need. Society is, with all the technology, with everything is going on, and socially, and technology, and everything, technologically, in any which way you want to call it, is going through this babyizing process. Less and less responsibility, less pain, take care of me. You know, I want everything to be take care of me while I sleep, or while I'm having a good time,
or easy.
You know, it's just a press of a button. Anything else is the truth of the matter is that if you want to accomplish something in this life, even physically, even financially, it doesn't matter. Kalvachoma spiritually, the Indian is you go through a difficulty. And you accept it as what you need to do. Kodesh Baruch Hu doesn't need you to work to give you food. He does not. You need to work. If you don't work, you won't get. Up to a point. The point is that you need to work to develop your tools of responsibility, of learning to go through things. When you give your word, you're supposed to keep it. When you have things to take care of, you take care of them. When you have things that you don't feel like facing, you have to face them. This builds you. It makes you into a keli that Kadosh Baruch Hu can afterwards give you. What can you give to a baby? You want to be a baby? Fine, so you're a baby. So Kadosh Baruch Hu will feed you like a baby, no problem. And what can you give to a baby? You can give a baby food, you know, some milk, and a clean diaper. That's it. And maybe a little, you know, these toys on top of the crib, you know, turns into these little plastic animals, whatever it is. Dun, 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 dun. That's what you give a baby, that's it. But if you want to grow, you want to be a man, you want to be what a human being can be, you have to go through whatever you have to go through. That frustration, you know, forbids you from building your kelim. So Bezat Hashem, HaKadosh Baruch Hu should give us everything nice and easy.
Not plastic toys.
Listen, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, everything is possible. You want to create the entire world without Itarut Adel Tata. Create the entire world without anybody having to do a lot of hard work, or any hard work at all. Right? So you can also do Caleb. But the point is, just believe him. Believe HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the schools of the Tzaddik, you are led the right way, bring you to where you need to get, Bezrat Hashem. Come closer to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Every once in a while, you get to taste a real good herring. You get to taste a real good life. You know, no, not just good herring physically, but spiritually. You can hear some good things. To be continued tomorrow.